wanted to get a couple of tags that Jasmine put out. One's an older one, and one's the latest one as of today. So let's crack on those two. The first one is a 5-question tag. And number one is, do you have any paintings that were made by anyone in your family? No, I do not, unfortunately. Number two, excuse me sniffing. Have you had any problems uploading your videos lately? No, not really. They just take an absolute age to do. But apart from that, no, not really. Number three, do you look straight ahead or look down as you're walking? Well, I've always been instructed. I was instructed when I was young, young lady, to always walk with good posture. And my mother, she was very strict on things like that, ladylike behaviour and positions that you sit in and whatever. And she always used to say to me, put your shoulders back, your tummy in, and your chin up. And that was the way I had to walk. And if I didn't, she used to slap me across my chest and whack me across my bum. And you know, she'd correct it. She'd adjust my posture. But certain things stay with you. So yes, I do. I tend to look a bit haughty when I'm walking down the street. And yeah, that's quite an interesting question there, Jazz. Number four, last time you woke up with a stiff neck. I can't remember the last time I woke up with a stiff neck. I do try and get my position right at night because of my back. So I tend to, you know, sort of have pillars in the crook of my neck here so that I can, you know, keep it, my spine in line. And I lay on the floor as well, as you know, so. Number five, last but not least, do you like where you're living or do you feel it's time to move on? I'm liking the area that I live in less and less, really. When I moved here in 1978, I think it was, where my parents live around the corner, it was a much quieter area. It was not built up. And then in the mid, sort of early 80s, the kind of yuppies moved in. And basically it became a little Oxford Street, and now the price of houses have shot up, rents have shot up, you know, just a shop around the corner is very expensive. So I'd love to move on, to be honest with you, I really would. I'd like to go to Cyprus though, that's the only thing, because I don't think it would be any different in any part of London. I wouldn't like to live in a less expensive area because you've got other troubles and other problems there with gangs and guns. But anyway, good questions there, Jazz. Let's move on to the most recent one. It's 10 questions, so I better hurry on a bit because it's been 4 minutes and 50 already. Number one, who is or was your favourite wrestler? I used to watch Big Daddy, I think that's his name, back in the 70s when I was a kid. I used to sit next to my dad. Watch wrestling with him, but I'm not overly keen. Number two, what do you feel about people swearing? Well, that's a good question too. I don't actually like it. I especially don't like it directed at me, but having said that, I've acquired the habit myself, and it's really, really hard to drop, and I'm really working on it. Yeah, I really don't like people swearing, not at me anyway. What they do in the privacy of their own home is entirely up to them. Number three, which month of the year you just can't wait to see the back off? Well, here actually, I don't like the winter months. Not because of the cold, because you can always wrap up, but because the mornings are very dark. And the evenings, late afternoon get dark very early, and it's just not pleasant, you know, so I can't wait to see the back of the winter, really. And I suppose that goes right on into February, really, early Feb. Right about my birthday, you know, it's really, really dark. My birthday's January. full time. Getting up in the morning is a nightmare. But anyway, number three, which I'm going to touch on that one. Number four, ever confide in someone about yourself only to find out afterwards I was been told. Of course, things, you know, it's rare that it'll get back to me. Years ago, it would be rare. But then again, now, I don't actually have anybody that I confide in anywhere. I've made a couple of friends on here, actually, on YouTube. And so, I feel safe with those people. But in real world, I don't have friends that can do that to me. I've been through that, and I won't go through that ever again. There's no way. I don't know. Name some foods you don't like. Because I love food. Anchovies. Can't stand anchovies. Very, very fishy and salty. And same with caviar. I've tried caviar. Don't like caviar. What else don't I like? Oh my gosh. There's a Greek dish called fasolia, which I absolutely detest. Detest with a passion. What else don't I like? Crumbs. See, I love my food really. Can't think of any at the top of my head. I'll probably have tons later, but I'm editing it. But anyway, that's that. Do you listen to idle gossip? No, I'm very good like that actually. If somebody says someone is really bad or whatever, you know, just I don't really want to know. I like to make up my own mind, and usually I end up getting hurt and finding out that they're right. But I don't like to just listen to idle gossip and just make a judgment based on somebody else's judgment, unless I really trust them and trust their judgment. My Nigel, if he told me this person, that person, then you know, knowing me, I'd probably believe him and whatever. But no, I don't usually listen to idle gossip. Number seven, have you started to put your heating on yet? Yep, have. Yeah, it's got a bit nippy in the mornings, and have to put it on. Why do you like doing tags? I like doing tags because I like speaking about myself, really. Oh dear. Okay, that's partly true, but also I like to watch hear tags. You know, just get to know people, and people are so diverse. It's really interesting, and also it's thought provoking. I like questions. I like people posing questions at me because I like to think. I'm a deep person. I like to think and voice my own opinion. Call me opinionated if you like. But hey ho. Number nine. Is there anyone in your family that don't understand you? Not now, but when I first became a Christian, it was a conversion kind of thing, if you like. I found my faith, found religion, and that certainly didn't go down well with anyone in my family. They didn't understand me at all, but now that I've stuck with it, if you like, for the last 20 odd years, and I live by my faith, or I try to anyway, they kind of understand me now. And hopefully they respect me a little bit more too. What else? Last but not least, do you have a dictionary? No, I don't have a dictionary in the house. Namely because I don't actually need one. I use dictionaries online. I'm always referring to that, and I kind of have a favourite website that I go to. And yeah, that's it. There you go. Tags done. All 15 questions. I hope you like jazz. I hope everybody else appreciated. And have a wonderful day. I may well come back in a bit. Have a little chat with you. But take it easy, okay? The buff will keep it real.